Hop House.
Thank you, Madam Deputy Speaker. Can I also congratulate the Honourable Member for Warwick and Leamington for his excellent speech. What an honour it must be to represent such a happy, diverse and, may I say, sensible community. No deal, no way. I completely agree, and his constituents seem to be much more clear-sighted than some members on the opposite benches. Madam Deputy Speaker, can I remind the government to start taking the Brexit negotiations seriously? Can I also remind the government that the British people deserve the right to have their personal data protected both here and cross-border? And as we have already heard today, there are many complications post-Brexit. The cross-border General Data Protection Regulation will be brought in by the EU and will be applicable here in the UK in May 2018. But for post-Brexit Britain, there is no clarity for how data protection will be regulated, because it is entirely up to the Phase 2 negotiation, and we haven't even started them. Business needs clarity. Data protection regulation is a vital issue for the technology sector. This will affect the sector in every way, whether it is for individuals buying something online or logging into Facebook, or for large companies operating internationally. The tech sector is one of the success stories for the UK, as we have also heard today. It provides 10% of our GDP, 24% of our exports, and over 3 million jobs. And the issue of data protection is not just central for the tech sector, but for our whole economy. Any business of any size needs to be able to transfer data across borders and to do so safely. If we leave without a deal on data protection, British business will simply not be able to operate internationally. So much for the government's vision of a global Britain. We have already seen how Brexit is beginning to damage the economy. The uncertainty facing the tech sector is just another example of how serious a no-deal scenario would be for the whole of the economy. And the honourable members opposite cannot claim to be the party of business if they can seriously say that no deal is a better deal, is better than a bad deal. No deal is a very worst deal that we can have. The government says they will negotiate an adequacy agreement or an even enhanced agreement. But as we see time and again, what the government says that they will get and what they achieve are often very different things. While the EU General Data Protection Regulation will come into effect in 2018, before we leave, the European Commission will still have to agree that the UK is providing adequate levels of data protection after we leave. However, a few years ago, the European Court of Justice deemed aspects of the UK's Data Retention and Investigatory Powers Act as illegal. Ironically, this case was brought to the ACJ by the Honourable Member, who is now the Secretary of State for exiting the EU. But it demonstrates the UK has a history of failing to comply with EU data protection rules. Once outside the EU, the Commission will regularly review whether they think UK data protection regulations are acceptable. We'll have to agree with their regulations, which are under ECJ oversight, but without any say. That will be the reality post-Brexit, and it is important that all of us come to terms with these realities. Frankly, I doubt that the government in the Brexit negotiations will even get to the issue that we are discussing here today. This week has been full of talks of no deal. We know the clock is ticking, and as we heard today, negotiations in Brussels are at a deadlock. It is for this government to unlock that deadlock. The Prime Minister has the cheek to say the ball is in the EU's court. I would say this government has failed to even pick up the racket, let alone hit the ball over the net. Thank you, Madam Deputy.
Jim Shannon.